Hello students, welcome to Parijnan Mentors. This is NCERT Unit 10 Quadratic Equations. Total marks 6 marks. You must remember the following. Polynomials is called quadratic equation when highest power of x equal to 2. You always compare with standard form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. One term is in x square and one other term is in the lower order of x or constant. Example 1, x square minus 6x plus 8 is equal to 0. Comparing this with ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, we get a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 6, c is equal to plus 8. A, b, c are coefficients of x square, x and constant terms. If the term has minus, then you put the minus sign in the constant. Next slide. Example 2, x squared is equal to 9. When we simplify, we get x squared minus 9 is x term is missing. So you can say x is 0. You can say a is equal to 1, b is equal to 0, c is equal to minus 9. Example 2, example 3, in minus 2x square plus 6x equal to 0, compare to standard form. We get a is equal to minus 2, b is equal to 6, c is equal to 0. Whatever the given equation is, you should try to bring it to the standard form. Example 4, x squared minus 2x is equal to minus 2 into bracket 3 minus x. Open the right hand side bracket, you get minus 6 plus 2x is x squared minus 2x is equal to 2x minus 6. Bring all the terms to the left, we get x squared minus 2x minus 2x plus 6 is equal to 0, or x square minus 4x x plus 6 is equal to 0. Here is a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 4, c is equal to plus 6. Next slide. 3 methods of solving. One is factorization. Second is completing the square. Third is using the formula. First, factorization. On question 2x squared plus x minus 6 is equal to 0. Compare this with standard form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We get a is equal to 2, c is equal to minus 6. Factors, if you factorize, 2 into minus 6 is 12. Factors of 12 are 6 into 2 or 4 into 3. By manipulating these, we get b value is equal to plus 1. Because 4 plus 3 is 7, so that is not possible. 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So this is the correct one. So the central term can be split into 2x squared plus 4x minus 3x minus 6 is equal to 0. Thus, the first two terms and next two terms are 2x squared plus 4x minus 3x minus 6x. You take out the common factors. What do you get? 2x into bracket x plus 2 minus 3 into bracket x plus 2. Now x plus 2 is common here. So taking x plus 2 common, we get into one bracket x plus 2, another bracket, you get 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. So x plus 2 is equal to 0 or x equal to minus 2. And the other one is 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. So 2x is equal to 3 or x equal to 3 by 2. So roots are minus 2 or 3 by 2 . Let's look at method of completing the square. Solving the quadratic equation using the complete square method. Example 10.3.1, the first problem we are taken from the book. 2x squared minus 7x plus 3 is equal to 0. Here you can see the value of a is equal to 2, the first term 2x squared. So since this is not a complete square, what you have to do is you have to multiply it by the same number, that is multiply by 2, you get 4x squared minus 14x plus 6 is equal to 0. This is the new quadratic equation. And now you will see that the first term is 4x squared, which is a complete square. So you can write 4x squared as 2x whole squared. Okay. And it can be written as a squared minus 2ab plus b squared pattern, and you will get the value of a as 2x. The center term now is very important. How to get it is minus 14x, that is 2ab is equal to minus 14x. So b can be found out by dividing minus 14x by 2a, that is 2 times a, that is 4x. So minus 14x divided by 4x, when you do, you will get 7 by 2. So that is why we have multiplied this by b, which is 7 by 2. Okay, and then to make it complete square, again you have to make it 7 by 2 whole squared. Now since 7 by 2 whole squared has been added, we don't want the value to change, so you are making it minus 7 by 2 whole squared, and originally the term plus 6 is already there. So the whole thing can be rewritten as 2x minus 7 by 2 whole squared minus 49 by 4 plus 6, which becomes minus 25 by 4. So now it is in the form a squared minus b squared, which is nothing but you can write it as a plus b into bracket a minus b. That means you rewrite it as 2x minus 7 by 2 plus 5 by 2, that is a plus b, and in another bracket it will be 2x minus 7 by 2 minus 5 by 2. If you simplify that, you will get 2x minus 2 by 2 equal to 0, that is one equation, and then 2x minus 6 is equal to 0, that is the second equation. If you solve those, then 2x minus 1 is equal to 0. So 2x equal to 1 or x equal to half, that is one solution. Second solution is 2x minus 6 is equal to 0, 2x equal to 6, so x becomes 3. This is the other solution. So this is, problem is very easy to do. You can get about 3 marks in this. Only problem will be finding out the value of b and how to put it. Value of b, how to find, I already told you. So if you follow that method, practice it little bit, then you'll be able to get it. Let us move on to the next problem, that is problem number 3, 10.3.1 exercise. Here the problem is 4x squared plus 4 root 3x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now, unlike the previous problem, here already 4x squared is a complete square as it is given. So, you don't have to do any multiplication or anything. So, it can be written simply as 2x whole squared, and therefore the value of a is already known. Okay. Now, to find the value of b, I already told you the value of b will be always middle term divided by 2 times a. So, in this case, middle term is 4 root 3x, and then if you divide it by 2 times 2x, then you will get b is equal to root 3. This is the value of b. Now, the whole equation can be written as 2x squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Okay, that is a squared plus 2ab plus b squared format. And then, since you have added b squared, additionally root 3 whole squared, that is b term squared, you are going to subtract that so that the value doesn't change. This you must remember. It will be minus b squared, and then c originally was already there. So, you get a plus b whole squared, that is a is 2x and b is root 3. So, 2x plus root 3 whole squared and minus 3 plus 3, that becomes 0. So, 2x plus 3, 2x plus root 3 whole squared is equal to 0. So, there the roots are equal here. Unlike the previous problem where there were two roots, and this is the roots are equal here, then you get 2x is equal to minus root 3. So, x is equal to minus root 3 by 2. So, the nature of the roots, they are real and equal. So, this is the other type of problem we will get. You might get in the exam where it is already an existing complete square. So, please remember these two types, but you have to practice this. Unless you do that, you will not be able to get it so easily. So, next we will go to the formula method of finding out the equation, roots of the equation of a quadratic type. We now come to the third type of solution, that is using the formula. Solving the quadratic equation 2x squared minus 7x plus 3 is equal to 0 using the formula. You must compare this with standard form, that is ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So you will get a is equal to plus 2, b is equal to minus 7, c is equal to plus 3. And whenever there is any minus term, you have to be very, very careful. Here in this case, b is minus 7. So, the formula is solution of for the roots is x is equal to minus b plus minus root of b squared minus 4ac. Remember, the whole thing divided by 2a. Some people put it only partially, then it will go wrong. Entirely you have to put it divided by 2a. Therefore, the roots are x equal to, remember, always have the practice of putting brackets, that is minus b means minus into bracket b value is minus 7, that is minus into bracket minus 7 plus minus root of minus 7 whole squared minus 4 into a into c, that is 2 into 3. The whole thing divided by 2a. So, you get 7 plus minus root of 49 minus 24, which is divided by 4, which is 25 by 4. So, 7 plus minus root of 25 is nothing but 5. So you get 7 plus minus 5 divided by 4. That means 1 root is 7 plus 5 divided by 4. That is 7 plus 5 is 12 divided by 4, or x equal to 3. The other root is 7 minus 5 by 2, 5 by 4, which is 2 by 4. So x equal to half. So this is the way, the easiest way to solve the problem using the formula. Only thing is, two things you have to be very careful. One is, whenever there is a minus sign of a term, you have to be very careful, and then when you put the value of minus b. Second thing is, the whole thing divided by 2a. You must put it that way, otherwise the whole answer will go wrong. So let us look at next. Nature of the roots of a quadratic equation. We always look at the standard form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, and in this the value of b squared minus 4ac, that is called as discriminant. Okay, so there will be three types or three values for this discriminant. One, it can be positive. If it is greater than 0, then the roots are real, and it may be equal to 0, in which case the roots are equal, and it may be a negative value, in which case the roots are not real, or they are called they are imaginary. Many times you get questions on this for 1 or 2 marks, so always you practice this well. Let us look at three different types of examples from exercise 10.4. The first problem is 2x squared plus 3x plus 5 is equal to 0. You get the values comparing the standard term . Get a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 3, c is equal to 5. So the value of b squared minus 4ac, that is discriminant, will be whatever value you get, properly put it with the sign, that is minus 3 whole squared, then minus 4 a into c, that is minus 4 into 2 into 5. So the value becomes minus 31. So since the value is negative, the roots are not real, or they are imaginary. This is what you would write. They may ask you for the nature of the roots. Another type, 10.4.1, second example, 3x squared minus 4 root 3x plus 4 is equal to 0. Again, value of a is equal to 3, b is equal to minus 4 root 3, c is equal to 4. So b squared minus 4ac in this particular case becomes 16 into 3 minus 4 into 3 into 4, which is 48 minus 48 is equal to 0. So whenever it is 0, nature of the root is they are equal. And what is the value of those roots? There is one formula for value of the roots which is given whenever they are equal, is minus b by 2a. So you just put the value of b by minus b by 2a and it becomes 2 root 3. Next problem, third one, 2x squared minus 6x plus 3. In this particular case, if you substitute the values of a, b, c, you will get it as b squared minus 4ac, discriminant becomes 36 minus 24 is equal, which is equal to 12. So it is positive. Hence it is greater than 0. So the roots are real. This is the nature of the roots. So like that you have to write. So please practice this, and it is very easy to get 1 or 2 marks from this. And definitely either there, it will be there in the fill in the blanks of 1 mark or 2 mark questions. Thank you.